Hey guys, Zomac here, coming at you with report number two for the gaming news series that I've been going on with. This news report will be going for Rising Storm 2. Now, Rising Storm is a, well, was a World War II game based off the Rising Storm series. Rising Storm 2 will be the second of that Rising Storm series. Rising Storm is also Red Orchestra 1 and 2, which is also World War II, which is Soviets versus Germany. And many people should know what it is. If you don't, well, it's kind of like Call of Duty. They were tripwire inactive, and in E3 2015, Rising Storm 2 was announced as Rising Storm 2 Vietnam. And this Rising Storm will cover the American involvement in Vietnam. And in this very news report here, we are going to cover some of the weapons, some of the things that we would see, some things that I would like to see, some of the things that I think might be in the game, some facts, and some news that I found. And yeah, so let's go roll a video clip. And so everybody, just go get your popcorn and all. And yeah. All right, guys, so what we saw in this video here, we see some of the terrain very jungly, very dense, a lot of shrubbery, so your enemy could probably be hiding in there. Looks like napalm might be in the game because of the way these trees are burnt up. As you see here, we see an African American soldier. Have not seen those in any of the Rising Storms. We've seen M60, some M16s, different character styles, so there might be different character styles for different classes. Over here, we see AK-47s, Russian made, with some RPGs, again, Russian made. And there might be Viet Cong and NVA, I'm not sure. NVA meaning North Vietnamese Army. Over here, we see Hueys, so either those I'm probably going to be flyable, and those are the Huey D models. And we see M60s there mounted on the sides. And we see an RPG shoots this one down here, so. I don't know, there might be like a thing that you have to reclaim it for, like, hey, go out there and reclaim that Huey. Over here we see a Cobra. So seeing this Cobra and these M16s and these Hueys, it makes me believe, since I don't see SKSs or anything, that this is the Vietnam like late era, like 1968 to 1975, like that late. So yeah. All right, guys, so let's talk about what we saw in this video, and let's get a recap here, and I'll talk to you guys about the news that I found out. So anyways, let's start it off. Rising Storm 2 won PC Gamer's E3 2015 award of best PC game, so I can see some potential coming out of this game. And also, Vietnam War era games always give a kick in the people. I mean, I remember I used to play Arma 2 with my NW regiment, which means the Polonic Wars for a Mountain Blade DLC, and most of them were all British and European, and we used to play Arma 2, and there was a Vietnam mod that we all played, and my commander, even though he wasn't even American, got a kick out of the. I mean, he loved the Vietnam War. He loved Fortunate Son, riding in the helicopter, guns a-blazing, gunning Charlie down wherever he goes. And singing Fortunate Son reminds me, in the video, the soundtrack in the back, the song, for those of you who don't know, was CCR, Creedence Clearwater Revival. Their song was Run Through the Jungle, was the song playing in the background, which brings up The soundtrack. Now, so far, I can probably list off a lot of songs. We're probably going to see CCR with Fortunate Son, Run Through the Jungle, Bad Moon Rising, Down on the Corner, maybe some Jimi Hendrix there, Rolling Stones, definitely Animal, probably see Animal in there, The Arrows. I'm trying to think of it. There was one more band. Oh man, I can't remember the name. The one time I need to remember the name, I cannot remember its name. God, it was a popular band. No, I think I. Did I already say it? Yeah, I guess I did. I don't know. But yeah. So there's a lot of bands and all that I'll be playing with that music from the late '60s, early '70s when this time period is going to take place for this game. Anyways, so let's get to it. So since I saw no M14s. That's why I'm thinking, since I saw M16s, it's going to be late game. And so, yeah, so we'll probably be seeing M16s as your standard gun. M60s is maybe the machine gun. There might be M14s, but probably only for the sniper. And even the sniper might be using a Springfield. Rocket launchers, we'll probably be seeing the small, which was a rocket launcher then. For the enemy. SKSs might be your sniper rifle. AK-47s might be the standard gun. RPGs will be your rocket launcher. RPK or RP, I forget what it is. RPK, I think it is the machine gun. Or RGK, something like that. I'm not really good at Russian-made weapons. That might be your machine gun. Or you probably might just use a Detreski, I believe it was called, from World War II. But so yeah, so you might just be seeing that. Yeah, I don't know, you may not. But some of the maps, for those of you who've already played Red Orchestra or Rising Storm, you know there's like a battle map where you have to capture the points and you fight for them. If you look at the picture closely, if you, when you rewatch the video, it says Thailand, Vietnam, Cambodia, and Laos. So automatically that shows that there's gonna be a broad region of stuff. And so here are some of the things that I think are probably gonna be some things you have to capture. One is gonna be Saigon, the capital of South Vietnam and the US base of operations. Pleiku might be another region you have to capture in Vietnam. I remember my grandfather used to always tell me during the Tet Offensive, he was stationed in Pleiku, and that's where all the fighting was for when he was there. Khe San might be another place on the map, all those hills and stuff, and I can see a lot of hill fighting taking place in this game. Ho Chi Minh City, I believe. No, wait, Ho Chi Minh City is what they renamed Saigon. What was the North Vietnamese capital? I think it was like Hao Giang or something like that. Thailand, Cambodia, and Laos. I don't know. You'll probably be attacking the Ho Chi Minh Trail, going to Cambodia, because that's what Nixon made us do, going to Cambodia. Laos, we were always going into Thailand, though. I don't think we ever went into Thailand, so. But you might have to. I don't know. But, and maybe there's like certain routes you can cut off so the Russians don't support the NVA with weapons or. As the Vietnamese, if you capture Saigon, the American reinforcements are cut down. But tanks, I know the North Vietnamese or the Vietnamese are not, definitely are not going to have any helicopters. Fighter jets, I don't know if they'll have fighter jets. Tanks, I know they have to have tanks. But if so, tanks. We would probably have the Americans would probably have the was the M36 Patton, I believe. I might be mistaken. And the Vietnamese might have the T like 50 something or T-72. I don't know, something like that. Yeah, probably like a T-50. And I don't know if what they're gonna have for like gun carriers and stuff. Like I said, this is Tripwire Interactive's first time taking a crack at a post-World War II game. From what I know, their only shooter games they've ever made besides Killing Floor has been World War II. Like all Red Orchestras and the first Rising Storm was all World War II. So this is their first crack at it. So I'd really like to see that. Next game I would like to cover is stuff that I would like to see in the future. Maybe some boats for support if it's by the water. We probably won't see boats though. But maybe some boats here and there. They probably won't put boats into the game though. Fighter jets. I would like to see some aerial combat in the game, but like I said, they probably won't do that either. Release date for this game. There is no release date, but I'm saying maybe early spring of 2016. Right now, this video is coming out. The video that I'm making right now is coming out September 2015, late September, I should say, like the 27th, 28th, something like that. And so I'm saying like spring of 2016, so like March or April of 2016, maybe. But Napalm and Agent Orange, I don't know, that might be in the game. For those of you who don't know what Napalm is, it's basically like a firebomb, and Agent Orange was basically a weed killer that got dumped on the jungle, caused birth defects, caused heart problems in U.S. soldiers, stuff like that. So, but there's really not that much information. And if more information happens, like I said in the previous news episode, I will come back to it. And also, I have to confirm the Battlefront beta is actually October the 8th, not October the 4th. So it's only 4 days back. And another thing I like to say, I have a Rainbow Six Siege beta key, closed beta key, and I might start up a contest for it to give it out to someone, or I might just give it off to one of my friends. I do not know. I'm depicting on it now. So, put in the comment section below if you guys want to have it voted off or not. You guys have 2 days to put in the comments below if you want it voted or not, and put in the comment section below the next news video you want to see. If I don't get any comments because my channel is a little small. We have hit 51 subs, well, 50 subs in the previous episode, the previous news episode. Now we're at 51 subs and almost 6,000 views. So bravo, guys, bravo. That is great. When we hit 100 subs, I will do a video for you guys. But I have a special, how should I put this? Let's play coming out for hitting the 50 sub mark, and it will happen. It will come out every Tuesday, Thursday, and Sunday. Or no, Tuesday, Thursday, and Saturday. There we go. That sounds a little better because Sunday I'm kind of jam packed. So, like I said, I hope you guys all enjoyed this news episode. Put some more news things you want to see in the comment section below. All links where I got this information, like I said, will be in the comment section below because you know what? I will cite my sources so that you guys can see it for yourself. I believe there'll be two sources in there. So I hope you guys all enjoy this wonderful, wonderful game. When it comes out, go ahead and sign up. The website will tell you how to sign up. I'll put the website link in the description below. You can sign up to get information and all for this game when it comes out. It'll probably be released on Steam. So if you don't have Steam, you might want to go get it. If you don't have a computer, well, I don't think they'll be releasing this game for console since PC Gamer was the one who rated it. So guys kind of SOL there. I'm sorry, but so I hope you all enjoyed this video. Put in the comments below if there any changes you need to see. This picture's a low quality picture in the background there, but it's only there as a placeholder for you guys to stare at. So yeah, so I'm gonna go put some images in the video, and it'll just show off some clips that have been given on the website. So yeah, I'm gonna go show those, and I hope you all had a great time watching this news episode. And we're just gonna look at those clips, and we are gonna end the video there. So let's go look at those clips we got. All right, guys, so looking at those clips there, we get to see some of the gameplay looks. They're just screenshots as you see in the trailer, but for those of you who don't know anything about the Vietnam War, I would definitely suggest looking stuff up for it, just because the Vietnam War was, it's a hard to explain war. It was an unneeded war. That war should never have happened. But even I can say this, and many people can say this, unless like your family immigrated to the United States after 1973, or your family didn't join, they weren't drafted because they had a medical issue, or there wasn't enough children, or because they had to continue the family name because it was an only child, or something like I'm trying to think of, oh yeah, and like if you, like a religious purpose, like Islamic peoples, like Muhammad Ali believed in peace, so they did not go to the war. That from what I know of, Muhammad Ali didn't go to the war, and like many other people paid their way out of the draft. They hid from the draft, moved to Canada from the draft, and I think if you're Mormon, any Mormons didn't go to war, but I'm just thinking. But I think everybody at least has one family member, grandfather, uncle, father, brother, someone was in this war. I mean, in my side, in my family, I have three uncles, one grandfather, and my other uncle, he made it to the reserves, and that's where he sat in for a little bit, but because he had an eye problem, so they threw it, and they put him out before he really was in there, so he didn't get any vet benefits or anything because he never made it out of basic because he did an eye thing on him. But so like I said, guys, just look up some history about this war if you want to find out more about it. Just get into the field. And so yeah, I hope everybody, it doesn't matter what country you come from, I'm not saying war is a good thing, but in my eyes, war is a glorified thing. As a great person once said, I forget the guy's name, some journalist or whatever, said, when bombs stop dropping, humanity has lost all passion. And it's kind of true. If you have no patriotism for your country, that's when peace happens. Though I'm not saying peace isn't a good thing. Peace is a great thing, but sometimes war is needed, but most of the time it is not. But when war does happen, it should have its reasons. But the Vietnam War had its reasons up to a certain point, and after that it had no reason at all. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please don't forget to comment, rate, and subscribe. And this is Dom Dog signing out with leaving you guys with Rising Storm 2. Great news video. More information will come out when it becomes available. So stay tuned with this very great, in my opinion, very great newscast with your head anchor Dom Dog. And as I said, next Sunday we'll come out with the next weekly video. So do put in the comment section below what you want to see. And this is Dom Dog signing out. And stay tuned.